Make this your common practice. Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you can live together whole and healed. The prayer of a person living right with God is something powerful to be reckoned with. You see, make this your common practice. Confess your sins to each other is something we do not want to do. But God will orchestrate those opportunities in our lives through the relationships that we develop, where circumstances will come together where all of a sudden those particular issues are on the table in your mind, and God the Holy Spirit is leading you and confirming with you, and you know in your spirit that the Spirit of God is orchestrating it through that whole environment, that whole relationship, to reveal those truths to each other for the sake of healing. For the sake of, some people have scars in their lives that they're scars, they're behind you, you move forward, but at the same time, Satan uses those scars as artillery against us at very vulnerable times in our lives. But if we know that we have, that God has put someone in our life or others in our lives that we can be open with about those things, we might get the ammunition and the encouragement and the support and the understanding and, that we need to be able to heal ourselves and to stand that much stronger. That is something that God wants us to have in our lives. David Guzik, pastor of Calvary Chapel of Santa Barbara, had this to say about what James said in James 5:16. Quote, "Confession to another in the body of Christ is essential because sin will demand to have us because sin will demand to have us to itself, isolated from all others. Confession breaks the power of secret sin. Yet confession need not be made to a priest or any other imagined mediator. We simply confess to one another as appropriate. Confession is good, but listen, but must be made with discretion. And an unwise confession of sin can be the cause of more sin." He's correct. The more that we feel like we're in our own boat, our own island, our own situation, that nobody can relate to, that nobody can understand, the more we are drugged down in that boat to where we will begin to sink in that situation. But when we realize there are others that are in the back end of the boat with us, so to speak, that we know that can understand with compassion and understand truly, then there's a sense of not just a blessing, but that exposure breaks strongholds because it's humbling, it's revealing, and it's reassuring.